Hello, Super Set Maniacs! Welcome back to my channel. So today I'm delivering what I promised to you guys in my video with what if Kai Green had entered the 2020 Mr. Olympia. I made a promise to you that if that video will get 400 likes, I will do the video request with the most likes from the comment section. It's true that I was expecting a suggestion of that type of a video to win with someone on a certain bodybuilding stage, but you guys wanted this. Ranking every Mr. Olympia in their best shape. This comment won by a landslide with 30 plus likes. I believe second place did not even get 10 likes, so I had to deliver what you guys want. So I'm going to rank every Mr. Olympia winner from worst to best, from 16 to number 1. But guys, keep in mind that we're talking more than 50 years of history. We're talking different eras and different types of physique. So this is pretty difficult. The main criteria for my rankings are physique, impact on the sport, and legacy. So without any further ado, let's start with number 16, the 1982 Mr. Olympia, Chris Dickerson. Chris Dickerson is probably the least impressive Mr. Olympia winner of all time in terms of both physique and legacy. Between 79 and 84 we had 6 different Mr. Olympia winners. So this was one of those periods when we did not have an impressive Olympia reign. Chris Dickerson win in 82 did not mark a significant change to the sport. That was his only Olympia win. He did not have a standout body part or pose, but rather on the contrary, he was often criticized for his weird pointy elbows. So in our ranking today, Chris Dickerson gets the last place. On 15 is the 15th man himself, Brandon Curry. Brandon Curry is so low in this list because he, in spite of being a great ambassador for the sport, was one of the most criticized Mr. Olympia winners of all time. Firstly, he did not have any great competition in 2019 when he won the Olympia, with the former two Mr. Olympia winners, Sean Roden and Phil Heath, being absent at that show. Other big names like Big Ramy were missing too. And secondly, I believe his conditioning at that show was not worthy of an Olympia champion, as Dorian Yates have stated that he would look like that 6 weeks out from a show. Moreover, he did not successfully defend his title, losing it against Big Ramy at his first title defense. Number 14 is Larry Scott, the first ever Mr. Olympia winner. The one who won the first two editions of this show, actually. Aside from the fact that he is the first ever Olympian, we cannot remember too many other things about him. He had a lesser impact than other guys from the 60s and 70s like Sergio or Arnold, so he gets only number 14 in our list today. Lucky number 13 is Flexatron Sean Roden. He is a one-time Olympia winner. He won the show in 2018, stopping Phil Heath in his quest for his 8th consecutive Mr. Olympia title. He is so low in our list because he did not do anything significant as a Mr. Olympia aside from a controversial guest posing where he looked awful. Then he was banned from the Olympia because of those rape allegations, so he never had the chance to compete again after the 2018 Mr. Olympia. Another reason for why he is so low in our list is because many people consider that the only reason he won that show is because Phil Heath had a bad midsection and judges penalized him for that, being the second year in a row when he had a similar obvious issue. In number 12 we have another one-time winner, Samir Banu, the 1983 Mr. Olympia. Samir did not have a very impressive career, but the physique he presented at the 1983 Mr. Olympia was just outstanding. he presented a back development never seen before on a bodybuilding stage. He brought something new to the stage and raised the bar for future generations to follow. On 11th place, just missing the top 10, we have Franco Colombo. He is a two-time Olympian winner, winning the show in 1976 and 1981. He was a shorter guy and would spend most of his bodybuilding career in the shadow of his best friend Arnold Schwarzenegger. After Arnold retired in 75, Franco finally got the chance to win the Mr. Olympia in 76, and after that he retired to pursue a powerlifting career. He would come back in 81 and controversially win that year's Olympia, many people considering he was not worthy of the title that year. In number 10 we have the current Mr. Olympia champion Big Ramy. Before you go and unlike this video and unsubscribe, keep in mind that he is just a one-time Mr. Olympia winner so far, who still got a lot of time left, so by the end of his career he can climb much higher in this list, but for now, number 10 is enough. Number 9 is the three-time Mr. Olympia champion Frank Zane. He won the title in 77, 78 and 79. He is widely regarded as the godfather of aesthetics, because he was never the most massive or the most muscular guy on stage, but he compensated with great lines and artistic posing. Coming in number 8 is Dexter the Blade Jackson. In spite of holding the record for most pro show wins in history with 29, he is a one-time Olympia winner only. He won the show in 2008 when he capitalized on a off Jay Cutler, who just like in Phil Heath's case, was penalized by the judges for being off 2 years in a row, in my opinion. Coming in number 7 is the myth Sergio Oliva. He won the Olympia 3 times between 1967 and 1969, and he is the only man to have defeated Arnold Schwarzenegger on the Olympia stage in 1969. Sergio was way ahead of his time, being arguably the most genetically gifted bodybuilder of all time, having outstanding arms, a great back, and a very tiny waist. In number 6 we have Jay Cutler. He is a 4-time Mr. Olympia champion, winning the show in 06, 07, 09 and 2010. He's the one that ended Ronnie Coleman's Olympia reign in 2006. He placed second at the Mr. Olympia a record 6 times, placing 4 times behind Ronnie, 1 time behind Dexter, and 1 time behind Phil Heath. And speaking of Phil Heath, he is the number 5 spot in our ranking today. Phil Heath is a 7-time Mr. Olympia winner. He dominated the 2010s, and in my opinion, if it wasn't for that hernia and distended midsection issue, he would have been an 8, 9 or even 10 time champion, and we would have had a better ranking for him today. He still got time if he manages to fix that issue. Phil Heath, with a controlled midsection, is still the best bodybuilder in the world in my opinion. In number 4 we have the 6-time Olympia champion Dorian Yates, and he is ahead of Phil Heath because his competition in the 90s was much better than Phil's in the 2010s, I believe. Dorian Yates had probably the best competition in this entire list, and he gave no chance to people like Flex Wheeler, Kevin Levroni, Sean Ray and Nasser El-Sombari, just to name a few. Coming in number 3 is Lee Haney, the 8-time Mr. Olympia champion. In spite of holding the record for most Olympia wins tied with Ronnie Coleman, he is only 3rd because he was never as influential for the sport as Arnold or Ronnie Coleman are, who are our top 2. We'll see in a moment in what order. However, he is probably the best ambassador for the sport. He won 8 Mr. Olympia titles, no controversy. He retired at the age of 31, when most of the nowadays athletes get their pro cards. So this placing may be unfair for him indeed. Okay, so as an Olympia tradition, let's bring the top two in front of the stage, Arnold Schwarzenegger and Ronnie Coleman. Who is number one, guys? Well, Arnold did more for the sport than probably anyone else. He won the show 7 times, 6 times between 1970 and 1975, when he retired to pursue an acting career. He came back in 1980 and won the title for the 7th time. Then he became one of the most successful Hollywood actors. He was a governor. He did it all, guys. He made bodybuilding a more popular sport, and his physique in his prime is still considered by many as the ideal one. On the other hand, Ronnie Coleman is an 8-time Mr. Olympia champion. He is the most dominant Mr. Olympia winner of all time, and I believe that him in his prime is unbeatable. So who's number one, guys? Ronnie Coleman or Arnold? Well, in my opinion, the best Mr. Olympia winner and the best bodybuilder of all time is Ronnie Coleman. Unlike Arnold, who was a successful actor and politician, Ronnie Coleman built his name and his legacy only around bodybuilding. He is known for being the freakiest, the best, not for his movies, not for the other things, simply the best bodybuilder of all time. Yeah, buddy. What do you guys think about this video? Do you agree with my list? Let me know in the comment section below. Also, let's get this video to 1000 likes and I'll make a top 10 uncrowned Mr. Olympia list. What do you say? Is this a good deal? I think it is. Also, don't forget to subscribe so you won't miss any of my videos. Thank you guys and see you next time.